taking a spousal benefit could actually have a detrimental impact to your lifelong Social Security income. The easiest way to explain this, I think, is actually by way of an example. So let's imagine we have a husband and wife, both are age 62. The husband was the higher wage earner, and the wife actually didn't earn enough credits to get a Social Security benefit based on her own earnings record. However, she is due a spousal benefit at some point. So one of the rules about spousal benefits is, in order for her, in this case, to take the spousal benefit, her husband must be taking his benefit. So let's imagine they get together over dinner and decide that they want to start taking some Social Security income. So what they decide to do is to both take their benefits at age 62. So now they have two checks coming in. She's receiving her spousal benefit. He's receiving his reduced benefit, and it's reduced because he took it early at 62 as opposed to waiting. And now they both have two checks coming in. Let's also imagine that 5 years down the road, he passes away. So what's the basic rule on spousal benefits is if you have two Social Security checks coming into the household, hers is lower, his is bigger. When one person dies, and it doesn't matter who, the lower check disappears and the higher one remains. In this case, that higher check is actually a reduced age 62 benefit. So that means the survivor benefit for her is going to be a smaller check than if he would not have taken his benefit at age 62 and had instead delayed and earned additional credits and increased his Social Security benefit. So what we can see here is you really have to think through more than just one piece of the pie. You really need to do some contingency planning and what if scenarios. What if one of us dies early? Will the other one be okay with that reduced single Social Security check? What if we both live a long time? Well, maybe it would have made sense to delay our Social Security and get a bigger check and get more money from the administration over the lifetime of Social Security. That's not to say that there aren't times when taking Social Security at age 62 could make sense. What it means is your situation is unique. You have many variables that are specific to you and you alone, and make sure you understand the contingency plans. So I hope you like what you heard today and that it made sense to you. Please subscribe to our channel. Please like our page and you'll stay updated and you'll be able to watch a multitude of videos, really short 2 to 5 minute videos that cover a vast array of retirement topics that are important to you. So thanks for joining us today and you have a great day.
To watch other webinars, go to BowmanFinancialStrategies.com and learn about topics like Social Security maximization, Roth conversions, and tax-efficient distribution strategies in retirement.